Good morning students, I am Puneet Kumar from Gronda, working as assistant professor in RPIT college. Today we discuss in this video how to use the Modi method in the transportation problem. As earlier discussed in the previous video, we discussed the procedure or steps of Modi method. In the procedure or steps of Modi method, the first method is that find initial feasible solution by any three method. Here one question, W1, W2, W3, F1, F2 and F3, these are the cost are also given and these are the supply and these are the demand. In this question, first of all, we check the total of supply and demand will be equal or not. If the total of supply of demand and supply is equal, then this is a balance. And if the total of supply and total of demand are not equal, then this is the unbalanced problem. First of all, we clear this balance. But in this question, this is a already balanced problem. Now we use the BAM method. In the previous video, we also discussed the VAM method. First of all, we calculate the unit penalty, every row and every column by taking the list two cost difference. If we discuss in the first column, the minimum two cost, that is 7 and 8, and the difference is 1. In the second column, 5 and 5, the difference is 0. In the third column, 4 and 3, the difference is 1. Now, we calculate the unit penalty row-wise. In the first row, 5 and 4, the difference is 1. And in the second, 3 and 6, the difference is 3. And next is 5 and 6, the difference is 1. Now, we calculate the highest unit penalty 1 here. When we see 3 is the maximum and we draw the circle, and this is the front of second row. In the second row, the minimum cost, that is 3, and now we check here supply is 50 and demand is 40. We put the 40 and the third column will be deleted. Now we further move unit penalty 2. When we calculate the unit penalty 2, the maximum, that is 4, and we draw the circle, and this is the front of third row, and here the minimum cost, that is 5, and supply is 60 and demand is 120. So we put the 60 and row third will be deleted because the total of supply is satisfied. Now only 7, 5, 8 and 6 is available, and we calculate the unit penalty 3. When we calculate the unit penalty 3, there are in the 2 and 2, this is the tie. But when a question in the tie in the unit penalty, we check if we select this 2, the minimum cost element, that is 5, and if we select second 2, the minimum cost, that is 6. Here we select that cost element, the cost is minimum, that is 5, and supply is 70 and demand is 120, but 60 is already given, then remaining is 60 and supply is 70, but we only clear the demand only 60, that's why the column will be deleted. And now further, only single column is pending, 7 and 8, we directly put the supply and demand. After putting the supply and demand, we obtain the occupied cell and calculate the transportation cost. Now we move further in the Modi method. In the Modi method, first of all, we discuss about the first condition, that is M plus N minus 1 equal to occupied cell. Here M, number of row and number of column, minus 1 is equal to occupied cell. When we check number of row 3, number of column 1 and minus 1 is equal to 5 occupied cell. Now we check in the table 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. This is no degeneracy problem. If the m plus n minus 1 not equal to occupied cell, this is a degeneracy problem. We discuss it on further question. Now we further move. We calculate the ui and vj for calculating the cij. Cij in the previous video we discussed, determine row ui and determine column vj and calculate ui plus vj for occupied cell. These cells are known as occupied cell. So first of all, we put the occupied cell W1, W2 and W3. Here occupied cell, that is 7, 8. There, this is unoccupied. Occupied cell, unoccupied. Occupied cell, unoccupied. Occupied cell, unoccupied cell. We put U1, U2, U3, V1, V2, V3. And the cost is 18, 10, 60, 60, 40. The total of demand is 20, 120, 40, 70, 50, and 60. 180. This is supply and this is demand. Here we check in the procedure, we discuss the select the particular row or particular column where maximum number of allocation is mentioned. But now we check in the first column 2 occupied cells, second column 2 occupied, third column 1. First row 2 occupied, second row 2 occupied, third 1 occupied. So now we discuss, we assume let u1 is equal to 0. u1 is equal to 0. Here we come combination. First is u1 plus v1 is equal to 7. For calculating the Cij value, that is next u1 plus v2 is equal to 5, u2 plus v1 is equal to 8, u2 plus v3 is equal to 3, u3 plus v2 is equal to 5. Here we assume u1 is equal to 0. Now we put the value. When we put the u1 is equal to 0, then we find v1 is equal to 7, v2 is equal to 5. We calculate with the help of u1, v1 and v2. And here v1 already is calculate, that is value of 7. Then u2 is equal to 1, 8 minus 7, u2 value is already 1, calculate 1, and v3 is equal to 2, u3 plus v2, here v2 is available 5, and u3 is equal to 0. Okay students, now put this value here. U1 is equal to 0, u2 is equal to 1, u3 is equal to 0, v1 is equal to 7, v2 is equal to 5, and v3 is equal to 2. Now we further move in the next for calculating the Dij for unoccupied cell. From the table we put that value which are not occupied First one is occupied, second occupied, next is unoccupied, occupied, unoccupied, occupied, unoccupied, occupied, unoccupied. U1, U2 and U3. Here U1 is equal to 0, U2 is equal to 1, U3 is equal to 0, V1 equal to 7, V2 is equal to 5 and V3 is equal to 2. Now we calculate the Dij. Dij is equal to Cij minus Ui plus Vj. So first cell, that is D13. Here Cij is 4 minus U1 plus V3. U1 is equal to 0 plus V3 is equal to 2. D13 is equal to 2. Now we calculate this cell is D22 and Cij 6. U1 is equal to 1 plus V2 is equal to 5. 1 plus 5, 6, 6 minus 6, 0. Now D31, Cij is 9 minus U3 is equal to 0, V1 is equal to 7, 2. D33, Cij is equal to 6 minus U3, 0 plus V3, 2, the value of 4. In the procedure we discuss, if all Dij greater than or equal to 0, then our solution is optimum solution. In this question we check all the Dij is greater than or equal to 0, that's why our solution is optimum. We can't further move in the next step. In the next video we discuss about the next step. It means that the transportation cost will not decrease from ₹870. This is the optimum solution. Then optimum transportation cost will be ₹870. Okay, students, thank you so much.